of the best ballparks you'll find in the sport, PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Ought to be a good one here between the Chicago White Sox and the Oakland A's. A's baseball starts right now. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He will lead this one off today. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Shaping up to be a pretty nice day for baseball. 69 degrees here at first pitch. All even now, 2-2.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
Here's another 2-2. Swing and a liner. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Marte is there and he has it for the first down. The next batter will be Luis Robert.
The center fielder, Luis.
First inning as we're just underway from Pittsburgh. Swinging a blooper to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit.
That is third. The first baseman is there.
Throw over to the bag. And the runner will get back standing. In now, Jose Abreu. That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now. And this is a strike three call. Oh, caught a break there. Two away. Ready now for the White Sox. Eloy Jimenez. His career numbers in this matchup. He's 2-for-4.
Runner
goes for second. Hit down the third baseline. Chapman has it cleanly. Rolando Olsen will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. So now here is Josh Harrison. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Two and two the count. Into the windup and the pitch. And it's fouled away. And he fouls this one off. He finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Batting second.
Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring up Starling Marte. Line drive to center field, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Batting third. The first baseman. Matt.
Stepping in now, Matt Olson, fouled away. Now another 1-2. Runners off for second. Pitch misses low. The throw down is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away.
Batting four.
Striding in for Oakland, Mark Canna. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. The set and the 2-2. Line drive, base hit to right. Marte isn't stopping. Here he comes to the plate. A tag and he's safe. They've taken the lead.
That is good. The right fielder.
Into the box now, Seth Brown. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Now Now to the plate, Yoan Moncada. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's just 1-for-6. The 1-1 home. Misses, ball two. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And a jam shot here as this is sent towards second. Scooped up on the first, and there's one gone here to start the second. So one out and nobody aboard. That'll bring up Yasmani Grandal. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Not much you could do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
Nope.
Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. He pops him up toward the left side of the infield. And there's out number 2. Up next for Chicago, Gavin Sheets.
Gavin Sheets.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. Grounded to short. Gloved by Harrison. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Now to bat, Matt Chapman. His prior history versus this arm, just a 2-for-14 line, so advantage pitcher here. He's gone down on strikes 8 times as well. Right down Main Street, caught him looking. So bases are empty with one gone, and that'll bring up the big-time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. Fouled off. This is swung on and missed. His 5th strikeout already, and there are 2 gone in the inning.
Batting it.
So the bases are empty here with 2 gone. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp.
Nope,
down low, 2 balls and a strike.
Oh,
a little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a 2-out base runner.
The catcher. John.
And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. In his career versus this pitcher, he's 0-for-5. And he may be starting to lose the feel here as that misses for ball 4, and that's back-to-back walks now with 2 away. And that'll bring up Josh Harrison. 2's all over the place. 2 on, 2 out, and of course, here in inning number 2. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter. Cutter, and that's a called strike 2. He's set. The 2-2. Down the third baseline. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And another foul ball. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Kemp on second. Murphy on at first with 2 down. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and up to the plate next is Andrew Vaughn. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double. To the plate now, Cesar Hernandez. And he struck him out. Back to the top of the White Sox lineup now, and stepping in, Tim Anderson. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Ball two. Count 2-1.
Swing and a looper to left. Left fielder coming on, but he won't get there. It falls in. The tying run is in to score from second. It's 1-1. At the plate, Luis Robert. A ball and two strikes now.
You rarely see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle, and man, as a hitter, probably a good chance you're not going to see that pitch again.
Struck him out. So a runner at first with two away, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will back next. Runner back safely. The 2-1 pitch.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. Digging in next will be Starling Marte. Fly ball right down the line and left. Jimenez is in pursuit. He's there and records the first down. And that'll bring up Matt Olson. 0 for 1 here in the early going. One out, nobody on.
Olson.
Let's see what they throw Olson on, a 3-1 count.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get in a more favorable.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one without a doubt is gone. Standing in now, Mark Canna. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. And it's fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
The 2-2. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
Jimenez is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now.
Number 15.
Next up for the A's, Seth Brown, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8, pitch 8.
He's got it. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Striding in is Eloy Jimenez. He bounced out last time up. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but he's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Got him. Digging in, the switch hitter, Yoan Moncada, grounded out in his last at bat. well outside with the curveball for a ball. Lined to short, but gobbled up there, and there are two away. And here's the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Big swing by Grandal, and a ball carrying well to right. And that one's wet, bounced right into the Allegheny. Into the box, Gavin Sheets. And yep, they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. High in the air out to center field. Marte is under it. And that ends the inning. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in this at-bat.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Back up the middle. Reined in. And he'll get in there safely.
The batter.
In now, Chris Davis. Chopper foul. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. And no strike, 3 called as he gets a little help there. 1 away. So 1 gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp. 2 balls and a strike. Here it is. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Racing back, the right fielder. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So now to the plate, Sean Murphy. 4 runs, 5 hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. Back up the middle. And there are 2 away now. So here is Josh Harrison, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Center fielder on the run. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with 2 away on a ground rule double. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Line to the right side. That's in there. Base hit. And they throw up the stop sign at third as they decide to play it safe with 2 away.
Now back. First baseman.
Stepping in now, Matt Olson. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Just a bit low, tough call, but it's 2-2.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to check.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Leading off the inning, it'll be Andrew Vaughn, and they could use a spark from him here.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Hit hard on the ground at first, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Stepping in once again is Cesar Hernandez. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. Into the windup and the pitch. Into right field. That's a base hit. At the plate now, Tim Anderson. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Hernandez, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a liner. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. At the plate, Luis Robert. Count all the way full to the White Sox center fielder.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Another full count pitch home. Drilled to the left side. And that's through into left, a base hit. The throw to the plate. And not in time as the run scores. To the plate now, Jose Abreu. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this is on the ground, is short. Could be two. Out. Back to first, but it's right over his head. And now this ball's going to wind up out of play. And that'll compound matters even further. Hit to third. Rolando Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Ronaldo Lopez, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and striding into bat next, it will be Mark Canna. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here comes the 1-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Next to hit, Seth Brown. No hits to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lined hard toward right center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Now batting, third baseman, Matt Chapman.
Standing in now, Matt Chapman. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Ball and two strikes, here it is. Fifth inning here of a tie ball game, 4-4. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Waiting on it is Jimenez. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Up next, Chris Davis. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot and has to put the ball in play.
Two balls and two strikes to count to Chris Davis. Change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of getting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Ready to take his hacks again. Tony Kemp blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was...
This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
The catcher. Gone.
End of the box, Sean Murphy. The count now at 2-2. Davis at second. Kemp at first. Two out in the inning. Drilled right back up the middle. Scooped up. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Plate now is Yoan Moncada. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. Now the 3-2 pitch. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. And this is taken in for out number one. Next up is Yasmani Grandal. Blasted a solo homer last time up.
To show you how strong this guy is, he hit that last off-speed pitch over 400 feet, so the pitcher wasn't supplying most of the power there. This is a really strong hitter.
Sinker misses, ball four. James Kaprielian enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Gavin Sheets will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. Here's the 3-1. Misses ball four, so he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. Now at the plate is Andrew Vaughn, trying here to plate the tying run from second. The 1-1.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Heading out towards shallow right. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. So next to hit is Cesar Hernandez. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Time, but to no avail as he went around and the inning is over. Josh Harrison stands in head to head with Ronaldo Lopez. He's hitless in three at bats. And now a swing and a routine fly ball out towards center, and that'll get down for a base hit. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
Up next, the pitcher, the first baseman.
At the plate now, Matt Olson. 2-1 to the A's first baseman.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
High in the air down the right field line. Vaughn is there, one away. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
The left fielder,
so here's the Oakland cleanup batter, Mark Canna. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Another payoff pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Looking up is the center fielder. To the track, to the wall. Gone!
Yeah.
Michael Kopech, the right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Michael Kopech.
Into the box now, Seth Brown. Three runs already home here. Just hung in there on that one.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And he fouls this one off. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Up next for Oakland.
Digging in next, Matt Chapman flew out last time up. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and stepping up as the shortstop, Tim Anderson. And he takes a big swing here, but this winds up a little tapper to the left of the mound. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. So next to bat will be Luis Robert. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Heading out towards shallow right. Brown in a few steps as he takes it. Two down. So two away here is the Sox bat in the seventh, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. Misses ball two. Skied into straightaway right. Brown finds some space out there for the catch to retire the Sox. Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring up the big-time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a little tapper. He'll try again, 1-2. Lays off, 2-2 now. Fouled away. The 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Digging in will be Tony Kemp. And if you remember, I'm sure he does, he hit a round tripper back in the fourth. Now the 3-2 pitch. Low ball four. In at the plate is Sean Murphy. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle.
Good job to work the count, put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And it's a foul ball. Good battle. Count remains full. Payoff pitch on its way. High in the air, carrying well out to deep center. Center fielder looking up at the track. The wall. Gone! At the plate, Josh Harrison. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Fouled off. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk. Here's Starling Marte.
Starling Marte.
The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Count is one and two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. So two are gone now in the Oakland half of the seventh. And that brings in the big power-hitting first baseman, Matt Olson. And a fastball that misses up in the zone here. It's 2-1.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
I got 3-1. Three balls.
And he lays off
strike.
Again. Ball three. The 3-1.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. He struck him out. The third time he's fanned in the game. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Eloy Jimenez. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. Center field. Marte is under it. One away. Next, it'll be Yoan Moncada. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. Easy tip there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside. Never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
So he sets him down swinging. Yoan Moncada goes down for out number two in the top half. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Jose Ruiz enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Number 64.
And stepping in, Mark Canna. Strike two taken, a fastball that clips the inside black. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
Ball two.
Bouncer up the middle. Anderson scoops it up. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Up next to
Stepping up is Seth Brown. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
I'm going to need to see a better game plan out of the hitter right here. That ball was at his eyes.
Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Next to stand in is Matt Chapman. He's got one hit in four at-bats.
Chapman.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. set to start the ninth in this one, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Gavin Sheets. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. And it's fouled away. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Andrew Vaughn the next to bat. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. After it is Martin. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Now at the plate, Cesar Hernandez. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And now a crowd right around 25,000 strong comes to their feet. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Marte is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Okay, this will wind up being one of those kind of saves you used to see back in the 70s. I'll tell you, he was on fumes at the end there, but he found a way to get it done.
10-4, the final in this game. The Athletics put a 10 spot on the scoreboard in this one. Chris Bassett is credited with the win. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First, for the victorious Athletics, 10 runs, 13 hits, 1 error, they left 8 runners on base.